So you want to become a full stack developer in 2022, but you don't know where to start. You don't necessarily have the time or energy or resources to go back to school for another 4 years to get your computer science degree. Does this mean your dreams of becoming a full stack developer are gone? Definitely not. As someone who has been there and has graduated with a degree that wasn't in computer science to now where I am today as a software developer, I can assure you there are so many different ways to getting there to becoming a full stack developer. Today, I'm going to be sharing with you some of my top courses I would suggest for anyone who is looking to become a full stack developer. These courses are taught by industry experts on full stack development. They are teachers that have been renowned for so long, and I'm so excited to share them with you. All of these courses are on Udemy, and honestly, I can say I have to give so much credit to Udemy, especially in the start of my career when I was learning and upskilling constantly. It's pretty much my number one resource, or it is my number one resource I go to when I need to learn something new. Before we get into it though, make sure to hit that subscribe button for more tech and coding related content. Give this video a thumbs up and also leave in the comments other video topics you want to see. Okay, let's dive into it. I'm going to go through the top five courses. The courses that I list are not in order from number one to five or five to one. These are all, in my opinion, equal on just the top five courses to become a full stack developer. The first one is by Dr. Angela. It's the Complete 2022 Web Development Bootcamp. Now, if you've taken any kind of coding related courses on Udemy before, you have definitely heard of Dr. Angela. She has some of the most top rated courses on Udemy when it comes to coding and technical related skills. So it's no surprise one of her courses is on the top five list. Okay, let's get into what about this course that I really love and what makes it stand out. Well, the first one is the length of it. This course is really done in a lengthy way where you're committing over 55 hours to this course. And yes, while that seems like a long time, imagine if you are someone who is coming in with next to no experience when it comes to full stack development. You are learning the basics from HTML, CSS, and then continuing building blocks on all throughout this course. Okay, I'm gonna pull up on screen here just a list of some of the technologies and tools you will learn in this course. So, as I mentioned, HTML, CSS, then it goes into Bootstrap, JavaScript, jQuery, and I love actually that it does focus on jQuery, at least touch on it a little bit. Now, some of you might say, well, jQuery is a bit outdated, it's not really used that often. It's still, in my opinion, so important to have a fundamental understanding about what it is, why it was used initially, and what has really taken over from jQuery. Then it goes into Git and GitHub and version control, which I think is so important. And it's something that when I was self-teaching myself or even went to a boot camp, that was really missed. So I love that she brings that into this course. And for full stack, you are going to be learning Node, Express, working with databases, with SQL, and also too with MongoDB. So I really like how she touches on that as well with authentication, Firebase, and then it goes into more front-end things with React, React Hooks, and web design. Another thing that stands out for me and another reason I would take this course is because you actually are building a physical, or not physical, a tangible product where you're building your portfolio. And I love how you can come out of this course with a portfolio already developed, and not to mention this is a certificate course. So once you complete it, you have a certificate, which is always a nice thing to put on your LinkedIn. I feel like I could talk about each of these courses for hours on end. I promise I will not. I'll just get to the highlights. And I think the reason behind my excitement for these courses is because they are so well done and so much time and effort is put into them. And as someone who has been there and has taken so many of these courses, I really, really appreciate the effort and the time and how these courses are laid out, that it truly is one of those courses, or all of these courses aren't wasting your time. You're not going to take them and regret taking them, which is so huge because there's so many different courses online that really you feel like at the end of it, why did I take this? It was a waste of time. And one thing I have found with Udemy is it's consistent. They always have the best courses and the best quality, and I never feel like I'm wasting my time. Okay, now that we have that out of the way, let's go into the next one. Next on the list is a course by Oak Academy called Full Stack Web Development with React, Angular, and Node. I really like how in this course they touch on both React and Angular, because a lot of courses just specify or touch on one front-end framework or library, and in this case you get to learn two. And I think it's really important to learn two because it really shows you the differences and similarities between different frameworks and libraries. And in this course, one of their mottos or motos, motto? Motto? motto, is to learn by doing, and you're going to be doing a lot of different projects in this course. So by the end of it, you'll have essentially a portfolio in itself with different projects in React and then also Angular. Also with this course, you have, actually with all of these courses, you can have zero experience going into it. So literally, if this is day one for you and you're like, I want to learn how to code, I want to become a full stack developer, this is for you. They really go from the basics, from HTML, CSS, and work their way up. The only caveat, I don't even know if it's a caveat, but the only thing to note is you have to be mentally committed to the time length. As I mentioned, the last course was 55 hours. This one is 36 hours, almost 37 hours. So you need to be in the mindset that this is going to take time. And this shouldn't come as a surprise to you. It should actually be seen as a positive, because any good course or any good teaching, it's going to give the appropriate amount of time to learning something so vast and so big. Okay, the next course on the list, and I'm sure you are not surprised, it involves Python, because a lot of our videos we've done recently together talk about how Python is the number one programming language in demand right now. It's just, it's everywhere right now. And that's a good thing, because Python is definitely a more user-friendly language to learn first, which is great that it is so in demand. So next on the list is Python and Django Full Stack Web Developer Bootcamp. Now this is a course that is around 31 hours, almost 32 hours in length. So once again, it's a full commitment course. But I do love how, unlike the last two courses I listed, it is focusing on Python. Now, I'm sure you're gonna stop this and be like, well, Tiff, what is better, Python, or should I learn JavaScript with React and Angular? What should I learn? There is no right answer. All the courses I am listing and what they are teaching are super in demand and very transferable. So whether you take a Python course or you take a JavaScript course, it's not going to affect if you get the job based one based on the other. If you learn Python, you can still apply for jobs in JavaScript and vice versa. It's not going to make or break. Employers understand that just having the skills of one means they're very transferable and you can easily pick up another. Okay, back to this course. So other things I really love about this course is it's taught through various different interactive ways. So through video lectures, through walkthrough code projects, exercises, downloadable course notes. I love when instructors give us notes to download, because a lot of times I will be referring to them in that moment, but saving them for later has become super handy, and it also helps me not to have to write so much of my own notes. And once again, this course as well has a certificate upon completion, which is another great thing to add to your LinkedIn. Okay, next on the list is the Web Developer Bootcamp 2022 by Colt Steel. Now, if you are a Udemy regular or have been on Udemy at all, if you are searching up any technology or coding related topics, I am sure you have heard of Colt Steel. He has some of the best courses out there, in my opinion. Some of the topics are really well broken down. His ratings are through the roof. I mean, 4.7 stars out of 5, and there has been over 220,000 ratings. That's crazy to have such a high rating with so many people rating you. So you know right there and then this is going to be a great course. One thing that stands out to me about this course is you really get to use some different tools. For example, I love that in this course you're actually using Postman to monitor and test different APIs. And that's something you're going to be doing in the real world. So getting familiar with these tools in a course is something that's really helpful, because then when you are in an interview and someone asks you, hey, have you used any of these tools? Have you used Postman? You can actually say, yes, I have. I use them to help build this project. Okay, last on the list, but not least on the list, is 100 Days of Code 2022 Web Developer Bootcamp by my personal favorite, I feel like I said it for every person, but Maximilian was one of my first, I think so many of his courses when I first started out, like almost all of them. So I have a huge soft spot for Max's courses because they are just so well done. And this course I really love because, once again, we are getting into it for 79 hours. So this is essentially like going to, okay, maybe not as much in length, but really going to a boot camp or going to a short form boot camp, because you are going to learn everything in and out and you have to be committed to this course. And what I really, really love about this course is it breaks it down into a learning path for you. So as you can see on screen here, there's days 1 to 5. What are we going to learn on day 1 to 5? Days 6 to 8, 9 to 10. And that is something that you don't really see in a lot of courses. And it's such a great way for anyone who really struggles to learn on their own or stay focused to realize that, hey, this is what I need to accomplish in this amount of days. Then I can have a break and then move on to the next part. Otherwise, taking a course can sometimes feel overwhelming to certain people, and not knowing when is enough for the day or when to stop or how much time should I put in. This course breaks it down for you, which I really love. Okay, those are my top five courses I would take if I wanted to become a full stack developer in 2022. Now, I think I've taken many of these courses, just different versions of them by the same instructors, 4 or 5 years ago when I was first starting out my coding journey in full stack development. And they are still super valuable for anyone who just wants to even up their skills, who's already in the industry as well. Okay, I hope you found this video super valuable and helpful. I'm curious to know, which course are you going to start taking? Leave down in the comments. I've linked Udemy down below, so make sure to go check it out. Thank you all, and I will see you soon.